President Obama is beginning his first full week as president with a massive to-do list on his desk. The economy tops on the domestic agenda, but his first calls to foreign leaders centered on the Mideast crisis. Our 39th President Jimmy Carter has a unique perspective on that area of the world, and his new book is called We Can Have Peace in the Holy Land, a plan that will work. President Carter, good morning to you.
Thank you, Meredith.
Before we get to the book, I want to talk about that moment at the inauguration that's gotten a lot of attention from the media and folks, where you warmly greeted President Bush Sr. and his wife Barbara, and then seemed to ignore President Clinton as you walked by. People said, is he snubbing him? What really happened, sir?
Well, we had already been with the Clintons for about 10 or 15 minutes as we waited for President Bush Sr. to come in. So we had warm greetings, already exchanged kisses with Hillary, and Rosen exchanged kisses with Bill. So we had already been intimately associated with them for 10 or 15 minutes before we came into the television view. That was why the difference. We were seeing the Bushes for the first time.
So there's no conflict whatsoever between you folks and the Clintons?
No, of course not.
Okay, let's talk a little bit about the inauguration. For the first time, President Obama addressed the Muslim world and extended a hand to them. No president has done that before. Then the first calls he made as president were to leaders in the Middle East. Were you pleased by both of those actions?
I was. I think it's very important that he bring them in. His first call, by the way, was to
the head of Fatah,
the head of Fatah, and also to Saudi Arabia and to Egypt, and also to Jordan. And those four calls were very important. And he's made an extremely important choice of his special envoy, George Mitchell, who's a tough, competent, aggressive negotiator, which we haven't had now for a long time.
And what does George Mitchell need to do? Now, he's heading out, I believe, today.
Yes, I talked to him yesterday. He's leaving this morning to go to a number of countries in the Middle East. Well, he needs to explore, I think, on this first visit, the elements that comprise the present situation. I was just over there last month in December and met with the top leaders involved in the process, including the Lebanese, and I was there quite extensively in April. But I think the first thing he needs to do is just size up what's going on and what can be done, in his opinion, after the debacle that we witnessed in Gaza.
Well, yeah, let's talk a little bit about that, because really this is about how do you begin the peace process when it might not be in Hamas's best interest right now. A lot of their power stems from conflict, so they may not be interested in putting down arms and going to the negotiating table. On the other hand, you have the Israeli settlers on the West Bank. They need to get out of there. They have quite clearly said, we're not going anywhere.
Well, Israel's got two basic choices. One is a one-state solution, which is a disaster for Israel and all its neighbors, and that's where they're heading right now. The other